Hello, everyone, and welcome to this week's edition of the Vinson Voice, a program where we talk about what's going on in VA around the country, and specifically what's happening here at the Carl Vinson VA Medical Center in beautiful Dublin in Lawrence County, Georgia. I'm your host, Dr. Frank Jordan, and the show's going to be very interesting today. We've been kind of starting off with some of our external stakeholders, those folks out in the community who team up with us. Today, we're going to kind of switch things up and put someone on the spot that I've been threatening to talk to for quite a while. This is Mr. Greg Swores. He's our photographer, media specialist here at the Medical Center, and he does all kinds of stuff for us, but most especially, he is always behind the camera. He's taking the pictures, he's doing the video, but I told him, Greg, we're going to get you in front of the camera and put you on the hot seat a little bit, so today is a day. Now, Greg is an Army veteran, retired from the U.S. Army, and was in a number of interesting locations, so we're going to thank Greg for his service. Greg, thank you.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about what you do here at the Medical Center and how you support our program services for America's Heroes.
Well, what I do here is I do all the photography for all our events and stuff. I do like the anybody that needs like portraiture done, you know, like for official portraits. I do all that. I also do a lot of graphic design, design, print. Posters, flyers, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. I assist the employees with that when they can't do it themselves. And I also do all the audiovisual stuff around the hospital, you know, something as simple as, you know, I can't get this to come up on screen. Right. And usually it's just
you're never as important as when it's time to get going and
right.
Something won't work with the AV or something else.
Right.
And that's when your phone rings off the hook, right?
Oh yeah, yeah. I'm always on the fly, you know. And the biggest thing is helping the folks here in order to support the ultimate mission, which is taking care of our veterans here.
Outstanding. That's exactly right. Yeah. Now, tell us how you started at the VA. Well, let's stop. Actually, let's go back to your military service. I want to hear a little bit about what you did in the Army first, mm-hmm. and then let's talk about how you ended up at the VA.
Okay. Well, I did 14 years in the Army. I did 11 years in the infantry and 3 years of recruiting, mm-hmm. which is... I probably got more PTSD from recruiting than I do actual combat. I served in Desert Storm with 1st Armored Division. I also went to Haiti with the 10th Mountain Division back in 1994.
Now that's interesting because I think when you were in Haiti, you met the president then, Aristide?
Yes, yes. We are actually our platoon, my platoon, the anti-tank platoon, we were President Aristide's motorcade security. So. We got to stay during the week. He would stay in the palace, so we stayed in the palace in the garage, and acted as a quick reaction force.
Right.
And then during the weekend, he would go home to his residence, and then we would, you know, perform guard duty around his residence.
Well, I tell people that our veterans are living history. One of the things I like to say is history walks these halls, and you're an example of that.
Thank
you're
you.
Not only a veteran who lived that history, but now you're supporting other veterans. That's fantastic.
Absolutely.
Now, Greg, I know you get involved in so much here at the Medical Center, it's just hard to keep up with you, but tell us, I know there are some things that really resonate in your heart that you really enjoy doing. Tell us some recent stuff, right?
Yes, definitely. I 4 years ago, I got the opportunity to go to the National Veteran Wheelchair Games down in Tampa, Florida, and I traveled with the team, and when I started capturing the images of the veterans actually competing, it set something off in my heart.
It's inspiring.
It is. It actually is. You know, they say disability, mm-hmm. but the way that they find ways to do the same thing that we would do it, mm-hmm. the different ways that they find a way is truly remarkable and inspiring, you know, like, wheelchair basketball.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we play basketball. Well, I've tried, but
you're not good at it.
No, I'm not good at it.
I can vouch for that.
Yeah, exactly. But the way that they play it, you know, find a way to adapt, you know, in their wheelchairs and stuff. It's I think disability is a horrible term for that. It's just inspiring how they.
Yeah, it really misleads because I know. With regard to the National Veterans Wheelchair Games, Golden Age Games, you might tend to think that there's some less level of intensity there, but it's inspiring to watch those people compete. I mean,
they
put every ounce of energy they've got into it. They take it very seriously, and the competition is fierce.
Yeah, and that's what keeps me going back is I want to capture those veterans' emotions. I want to capture their stories through my lens. and it's just really inspiring. It's even got me. This year was my first year going to the Golden Age Games, and it's kind of
in Detroit, right?
Yeah, that was in Detroit, Michigan, and it's got me kind of inspired to want to compete. You know,
you're getting in four more years. That age range.
Yeah, 50. You can be 54 if your birthday is in the same year of the game. So it's actually 55. So I'm wanting to get in shape and go myself and compete, because just seeing them is it's really emotional. The way you see the way that they compete, and it's like being back in the military again when you're around that group of guys and gals, and it's like you never left the military.
I hear that a lot from our employees.
Yeah, it's the camaraderie.
One of the things that's great about working at VA is it's almost like still being in the military. That camaraderie is still there. You actually meet people you know.
Yeah.
And our recreation services helps with the National Veterans Gold Wheelchair Games and Golden Age Games. So if any veterans are interested in that, they need to give us a call.
Absolutely.
So one week you're in Salt Lake City, Utah. The next week you're in Detroit. You're worn out.
That's right. Yeah, I'm kind of wore out.
But here you are back at work.
That's right. That's right. The days are really long, 19, 20-hour days, and doing it 6 days a week. You know, I lost 18 pounds at the wheelchair games, and that's just from doing averaging about 18,000 steps a day, and I carry about 25 to 30 pounds of camera equipment on me all the time. So it's, you know, so I lost that weight. I was really surprised.
No wonder you lost weight.
Yeah, I was really surprised. 100 degree weather.
Yeah.
Not as humid. Okay. They're in
Salt
Lake
City. Not the air you can wear like we have here.
Exactly. It's about 10% humidity there. Okay. You know, compared to our 110% humidity here. but yeah, it was really great. I did the same thing at the Golden Age Games in Detroit. And for the Golden Age Games in Detroit, I shot with the national media team that they sent.
And you've done so well that the national folks have asked you to start supporting them regularly.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
That's quite a compliment. Yeah,
it's all about the veterans to me.
That's right.
It's inspiring stuff, watching
those guys compete, seeing those pictures, it just grabs you in the heart. And your photography definitely captures it very well.
Thank you.
So, and just as an aside, you started here as a police officer, right?
I did. I started here as a police officer in 2003.
That's right.
And I actually kind of fell into this job in 2009 when the guy that was doing it before me, Ronald Carter, is a great guy, and he retired suddenly. And then I was asked if I could fill in until they found somebody, and when the job actually opened up, I applied.
They found me. You kind of like it. I tell you, you're like a duck in water when it comes to stuff, right?
Hey, don't let the dumb look fool you.
Greg, you have done your part. Military,
you.
Work for Veterans Affairs, stepping up when you call. We really appreciate everything you do for our veterans.
Thank you, Dr. Jordan.
And folks, we'll be back in just a few minutes with more Vincent Boys.
The Ice House is a beautifully restored warehouse in downtown Dublin that mixes Southern grace and history with an urban modern flair. Book your next special event today at 278-7224. The Ice House, downtown Dublin.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Vincent Voice. Next, we've got a good friend of mine here, Miss Angie Daniels. Now, Angie is with the American Legion and the American Legion Auxiliary. Did I get that right, Angie?
Yes.
Now, first of all, you need to know Angie is an Army veteran. Long time. We want to thank her for her service. Angie, thank you for what you've done for our country. Now, we're going to keep you here for a couple of segments. I'm just forewarning you because we want to hear a lot about the American Legion here in Dublin. It's the Paget Webb Post 17 American Legion Post, right here behind the VA, actually. Been there a long time and do some great stuff. And we wanted Angie and the American Legion folks here because they're one of our, what we call our external stakeholders. We keep emphasizing at the VA that we can't possibly serve America's heroes to the level we want to unless we have the community partners. And our veteran service organizations, or VSOs, like the American Legion, are integral to that. So, Angie, thank you for all you're doing there and continuing to serve America's heroes. Tell us a little bit about your military service before we talk about American Legion.
Well, I was in the Army. Mm-hmm. I was a delayed entry program person. And I got to go in early. I skipped from the 10th to the 12th grade. So I was able to have my parents sign for me so I could go. Mm-hmm. and just so happens I wound up being the youngest wherever I went. But I was with the 29th ASG out of Germany.
Okay.
And I had two different MOSs. and I was working on my third when I got hurt.
Wow. Yeah. Overachiever here, Angie.
Well, the more education you get, the better off you are.
Ah, but still my heart.
But the thing is with my original MOS, which was a 71 Lima pace per pusher, the more information I got for like the ammunition specialist and things like that, it opened up more job opportunities within the military for me.
Right.
And that's what I was trying to do. Plus, I was going to college at night.
Good job. My doctorate is in education, so anytime I hear someone mention education as a force in their lives, it really inspires me. I'm glad to hear that. Now, okay, so, you know, I joined the Navy because I wanted to travel. And I thought the Navy, well, they float everywhere they go. They're going to travel a lot. Turns out I'd probably been better served being in the Army, and particularly in Germany. Did you get to travel around while you were in Germany?
Yes, I did. I really did. I got to go to Turkey.
Oh, wow.
Of course, you know, it's central to everything else. So when we, on the weekends, we would travel, went to Paris.
That's fantastic.
I went to Switzerland, different places like that.
Yeah, that's what's so great about Germany. I hear that you're centrally located. So on the weekends, you take a few days leave. You can go pretty much anywhere in
Europe. You have to figure out things that you don't like and things that you love. Hang gliding off of the side of a mountain.
Oh, my gosh.
Skiing in Switzerland. I don't like skiing.
Yeah, skiing looks a little dangerous, believe it or not, to me.
I don't like it.
Okay, but thank you for your service, and that's fantastic. Now let's get into American Legion. I want people to know about American Legion, what it does, what it can do. So, and first of all, tell us what your position is there. I know you've done a few things. And you've got a new position now, right?
I just got sworn in as Senior Vice Commander, which is second in charge.
Right.
And I actually made history with that.
Okay.
I'm the first female senior vice since we opened.
Oh, wow. Okay.
In Dublin. So that's been almost 65, 70 years.
Oh, wow.
So.
I did not know the post had been open that long. That's fantastic.
Yes, it has. We have had different charters over the years, but yes, we have.
But it's affiliated with the national organization.
Yes. We are a national organization. Every city does not have an American Legion, but
anyone could apply for a charter, right?
Exactly. It's very easy to do. If you're a veteran within military wartime service, you can join. And we have this little motto that I use, and it's, we're after your time, not your money. Where most clubs and organizations want $250, $300 to join every year, ours is $35.
You want people to be active.
We want active volunteers, people that want to still be involved. Those of us that cannot work, but still need purpose and still need that drive. We're old or disabled, we're not useless.
Okay. And you're serving America's heroes, our veterans. That's,
well, it's a... Well, it's,
you know, it's, you can't beat a club that has a mission like that, right?
Well, it's a veterans organization, but we say veterans still serving veterans.
Right.
So we're still serving our country in a different way.
Outstanding. Now tell me the difference between American Legion and American Legion Auxiliary.
Okay, the American Legion are the vets themselves, male, female. The American Legion Auxiliary is our counterpart for all the females, the sisters, the wives,
who are not actually veterans.
Who were not actually veterans.
I like hearing that.
But it's a family organization. We have the sons of the American Legion for the sons, the fathers, the brothers, things like that that can be.
So what that does is opens it up. Anybody can
to anybody. And we also, if you don't have wartime veteran service or anything like that, we have volunteers. You know that you can come and volunteer with us. We have the Auxiliary Angels, which is the volunteers for the auxiliary, where the ladies can come in and volunteer with the auxiliary.
That's fantastic.
We also have the juniors. You are a junior from birth to 18 for the auxiliary, and then after 18, you are a full-fledged member of the auxiliary.
Now that's I'm glad you brought that point up because you know me, one of my concerns is that we're not generationally passing on the patriotism to our young people like we need to. And so anything that involves the youth is an outstanding opportunity to get them involved. So I'm glad to hear about
it. Several programs that does that through the auxiliary, through the Legion, and through the Sons.
That's fantastic.
We have Boy State, Girl State. We have so many different programs that I could get into.
And we expose them early, and then ideally they will go on to remember that they need support.
Yes.
Now I want to give that number out in case anyone's interested in participating before we get any further. It's 478-304-0121, and that's Miss Angie Daniels at the American Legion Pageant Web Post 17 here in Dublin, so she can get you involved if you want to be. And also go on their Facebook. Now, I was on your Facebook page this morning. I have to admit, I was remiss. I knew you had one, and I went on it a while back, had gotten out of the habit, but when I went on there, you guys, I say that you guys support us, but man, everything I post talking about events and things coming up, it's on there. So I went and I liked you guys. I'm going to be following you much more closely. But get on their Facebook page and see what's happening. That you guys did a great job with that.
Well, I try to spread the information because a lot of people, there's a lot of veterans that do not come to the VA. Mm-hmm. And the American Legion is not just VA oriented.
Right.
We go out into the community, try to reach veterans that way.
Right.
We have several different things that we do out in the community. We have a very, very small food pantry,
mm-hmm.
Just a couple of canned goods that we, you know,
every
try to keep.
Helps, Angie. Every
well, if somebody, someone called us up, they needed some help. What we did was we just threw together what we could, and we helped them get through the weekend till we could get someone that could help them.
That's fantastic.
And we don't have the room for a huge one, but we're mm-hmm. always trying to do a food drive or anything gotcha. Like that. Something to where a veteran, we have had to help transport a veteran mm-hmm. from one doctor's appointment to the other, even out of town.
Anything to do to help. And just stay right where you are. I'm not letting you go yet. Folks, we'll be right back with more Vincent Voice.
Since 1987, Little House Self Storage has been serving Dublin and Warner Robins with the best in customer service and the lowest prices anywhere. Any shape, any size, we have it, plus climate control. At Little House Self Storage, safety and security are our top priority. With TV security, special lighting, wide drives for easy access, and 24-hour-a-day access to the storage facility. We invite all businesses to remember Little House Self Storage for storing records, chip and cookie routes, or contractors. We can even store your car, motorhome, or airplane. Little House Self Storage, Moody Road, Warner Robins, and Marion Street in Dublin.
And folks, welcome back to the Vincent Voice. We're going to keep Angie Daniels here a few more minutes because there's so much the American Legion here in Dublin and around the nation does to support our veterans and the VAs. They're one of our biggest partners. So, Angie, during the break, you and I were talking about your Betsy Ross bit. Now, let's talk about that a little bit. I like that.
Well, I dress up as Betsy Ross, and I give a history of the American flag on how it came about mm-hmm. and things like that. And, you know, everyone talks about, you know, Washington came and told her to do this. Didn't actually happen that way, and that's why we talk about her. And she also was involved in several other things mm-hmm. throughout her life, patriotism-wise. And we give her, you know, her little due.
Right.
And we go to the schools and do it. We go to several organizations that invite us over. And this weekend, I'm actually going to Milledgeville.
Oh, fantastic.
So we try to spread out
mm-hmm.
The way we do things so that it's not just us sitting up here talking and boring. Yeah. We get out there and we reach people. I actually was very, very welcomed by Brookdale the weekend of the 4th, and they absolutely
enjoyed. Now, Brookdale,
enjoyed.
That's a, is that senior living center?
Brookdale Assisted Living,
assisted
yes.
Assisted Living, that's what
sorry.
That's
fine. And they welcomed me with open arms, or Betsy.
Now, see, I'm glad you said that, because when I'm here, I'm a history buff as well, you know that. And so when I hear you doing this Betsy Ross thing, and I've actually got a nice picture we're going to send of you doing your Betsy Ross presentation. But when I hear that, I'm hearing you're reaching children with the patriotism, and you're emphasizing that even as we go into the, you know, the later stage of our lives, we're still fascinated by our history, and it's still important, and it helps us spread that patriotism that's critical, right?
Well, yes, sir. And it's not just Betsy Ross. We have so many other programs that we offer the youth mm-hmm. And the elderly, or anybody, actually.
Yeah.
We have a program where we break down the American, the Pledge of Allegiance.
Right.
Most people have heard it from Red Skelton. We actually are implementing that. We had the flag folding ceremony. Mm-hmm. We had the POW MIA ceremony.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And actually, every time we do that, we try to get the POW MIA list of names from wherever we're at, so people in the community can actually know who in their community this was affected by.
Right.
There's a saying is, dying for your country is not the worst thing. Being forgotten is.
Right.
And right. We try not to.
And that's what the American Legion is doing. You're not letting these heroes be
no.
forgotten.
No. And right. I was very, very, very surprised that some of our old veterans or, you know, youth today didn't know what a Gold Star mother was.
Right,
what a,
right.
you know,
and
what
tell, and tell our audience, stop right there and tell our audience what a Gold Star mother is. Very important.
Our Gold Star mothers are mothers who have lost someone in battle.
Right.
And it's very important for us to remember them because they literally gave their children
these
to
are the people
the country.
Who are left behind when a veteran dies in combat. These are the ones who have to live with that. And have to
these are the
person,
tears so. That we have to wipe up
right.
after
right.
After it's all said and done. These are the people we have to answer to. Everybody's like, why are we at the war? Why are we at the war? The only person really and truly that I believe can ask that are the ones that are injured mm-hmm. and all the ones that the families that have been lost and the ones out there fighting now.
Yeah, I put a post by G.K. Chesterton on our Facebook the other day that said, soldiers fight not because they hate what's in front of them, but because they love those who are behind them.
And exactly. That
is, and I think sometimes when we get involved with numbers and politics and stuff, we forget that these are Americans, these are individual
people.
These
are lives.
Right, they're going out, they're defending their freedom. Some of them aren't coming back, and some of them are coming back with wounds that will never heal, and they'll have to live with the rest of their life.
And I would like to say something. Mm-hmm. A lot of the disabilities and a lot of the wounds are not physical.
Right.
And a lot of them don't show up right away.
That's right.
And the general public is getting better about that, but they still have a lot to learn when it comes to PTSD or...
military sexual trauma.
Oh my goodness, that mm-hmm. is really bad. So we are making strides to correct that between the VA, mm-hmm. other government programs, us.
And it's largely an educational
That's
process.
What I was going to say. We need to educate process. On everything. Education is just not mathematics. Education is life.
Right.
You
yeah.
learn something every day. You quit learning, you're not living.
I agree with that. And that's why when you guys share stuff on your Facebook and you talk about these things, that the VA is doing to try to offer PTSD services, preventing veteran suicides, military sexual trauma, homelessness mitigation, those types of things. That's why American Legion and these other VSOs are such critical partners to get that education out there and get these veterans to take advantage of what they earned.
One thing I would like to say, mm-hmm. whether you're with a company or organization or anything, if you know a veteran, pick up the phone. Sometimes, actually, it doesn't even have to be a veteran. Anyone that you know that is alone, pick up the phone, call them. Hey, I was thinking about you. I just wanted to see and hear your voice.
That's good.
You never know what that means to that one person.
That's absolutely right. And we tell our staff here, you know, some of our veterans, if you've got a family and you've got support, sometimes you take it for granted, but some of our veterans especially, they have us.
They have.
That's it.
That's it.
That's right.
But when you walk down these hallways, speak to the veterans.
Absolutely.
Speak to the if you have to, hey, all the way down the aisle. It doesn't matter.
Show
these
them the
corridors
love.
Are long enough
That's
that
right.
you can get your breath in between.
That's right. Show them the love. Angie, I want to get that number out one more time and remind everybody it's 478-304-0121. You can call Miss Angie Daniels anytime to try to find out how to join the American Legion, how you can support. And also remember their Facebook page. It's the Paget Webb American Legion Post 17, Dublin, Georgia page. Put that in any combination. It'll pop up because I tried it this morning. Angie, what you guys are doing at American Legion is fantastic. And the way you support VA and our efforts to try to honor American heroes, just can't say enough.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here. And
thank you for
you're going to be back in the future.
Okay.
Get ready. We're going to do the Betsy Ross thing. How about that?
All right.
All right.
Okay. I have to dress up as Betsy Ross?
Yes, you do.
We'll get you to dress up as Thomas Jefferson.
I'll do whatever you want me to do. You know me, I'm easy.
That's okay.
Folks, we'll be right back with more Vincent Voice. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Vincent Voice. We like to conclude the program by letting you know about some events that are coming up, some of the things that are going on here at the Medical Center. Let's see, August 3rd, 9:30 to 11:30 a.m. at the Shamrock Bowling Center here in Dublin. We're going to have a National Senior Games Association Bowling Clinic. Now, any veteran that uses a wheelchair is welcome, and they're welcome to bring family and friends to be in the audience and watch. If you want to participate in that, just contact Ms. Ceci Jones at cecilia.jones@va.gov. And that's Cecilia, cecilia.jones@va.gov. Or Charlene James at charlene.james@va.gov. Again, it's open to all veterans who use wheelchairs, and their families and friends are welcome to come take a look. And that's at the Shamrock Bowl on August 3rd. Also, in Tifton, we're very excited about our Tifton VA Clinic grand opening, which will be August 31st at 1:30 p.m. at the Tifton location. We hope everyone can come out and join us for that. We're going to get started with our Tifton VA Clinic services down there. Everyone in that area is excited, and so are we. So we're looking forward to that. Also, remember, you can take tours here at the Medical Center. Whether you're as an individual, you just want to come in and take a look at what we're doing and see our history, or you can bring groups. Just come on by. Give me a call at 478-274-5440 or send me an email at frank.jordan@va.gov, and that's Jordan, J-O-R-D-A-N. And we particularly want to emphasize bring the kids, church groups, school groups, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, whatever. Get the kids in here so they can see what we're doing to honor America's heroes. We need to keep that patriotism transmitted from generation to generation, folks, and that's one of the ways to do it. And don't forget to get on our social media. You can join us on Facebook at Dublin VA Medical Center. You can query that on a search engine and get our website, which is also www.dublin.va.gov. And don't forget to get on our Twitter feed, and our handle is @VADublin. Get on there, see what we're doing, see about programs and services, and share all this stuff, because the more veterans and their families and other stakeholders we reach, the more we can do for America's heroes, our veterans. Thank you once again for watching The Vincent Voice. We hope to see you next week.